Mike's run the trommel hard all season. Now he's down to the last 2 acres of the 18-acre megacut. With just 3 weeks' pay left to run, Tony's on the hunt for new ground to get him to his season goal.
I mean, the curious part about this part of the hill is there's all kinds of ditches and little ponds that people dug by hand in the olden days. In order for them to do that kind of work, there has to be a deposit somewhere. So you're just gonna have to follow them and see where the f*** did they go, what did they do, what did they know that I don't know yet.
Since the 1890s, miners have left their mark across Paradise Hill. The remains of their mine works could point to where the best gold was found.
Usually when you get all these spruce trees and you see a little path of birch trees just in the middle of nowhere there, that usually means that somebody had a shaft there or somebody been digging there, because birch trees don't grow on frozen ground. There you go, you got a shaft here. I don't know how deep he went.
Near one of the old timers' mine shafts, Tony finds what could be a vital clue.
You see that? There's quartz in there. And those are what you call indicators.
Where there's quartz, there's often gold.
This one here, I can just see in the pile, he's bringing up the same stuff as we got in the mega cut. My thing is, did he go deep enough?
The old timers dug these holes by hand, and Tony believes they may not have reached the pay layer. To find out if he's right, he brings in the 220 excavator to punch a test hole.
There is a couple of shafts out there. Are you? There you are, this blue house, and it's nothing but hydraulic oil. So here we are, gone. There goes your nice morning playing around in the boonies, I guess. Hey, Kevin, do you copy? Kevin, do you copy?
Oh, that one doesn't look right. Well, can't reattach it because she broke. Not just broke, but broke. This piece here is supposed to be over here.
While Kevin fixes the excavator, Tony continues to explore.
I've been here 35 years, and I've never been in these places. See, all these gullies here, you can clearly see that they monitored a whole big trench through there.
In the 1890s, old-timers used powerful hoses called monitors to blast pay dirt off the hill and into simple wooden sluice runs. Tony believes the parts of the hill that they missed could still contain thousands of ounces in gold.
You got the shaft here, we got a shaft over there. You can clearly see the monitors were in there. What the were they looking for?
120 yards east of the 50-foot shaft, Tony has discovered the exposed edge of an old-timer's monitored cut. The gold-rich pay should be much closer to the surface here, if they left any behind.
I don't think we're laughing. And that should be that.
Well, looks good to me, no leaks, I'm happy.
Tony can take it and keep on digging.
If Tony can find enough of the light-colored gravel that is rich in gold, this could be the ground to save his season.
Some of it definitely looks like pay dirt. See, that is white channel gravel. So, let's have a look at that. Do you test the pail of this? and I'll bet you're gonna get gold out of it.
Now, Tony needs to know how far the pay streak continues into the hill.
The thing is, what is behind here? What is underneath that nice gravel? So we're gonna poke a couple of holes with a drill and see what we can come up with.
He's found pay dirt left behind by the old timers.
All right.
And called in drilling expert Liam Ferguson to find out how far the pay streak extends under the hillside.
If you can poke one here,
yep,
anywhere in here, then I'll make another one over there.
Okay.
That's good enough.
Well, we're all set up, ready to go, so well, we'll put a few holes in and
That would be awesome. Like I say, the guy can find some resources on his own property these days. That's a plus.
For sure.
Because there's no new growing out there,
no,
right?
No.
Okay, good enough.
All right, see you, Tony.
Poke a hole with you.
Drilling comes at a price, $20,000 for just two test holes. Liam will drill the holes 300 feet apart to find out how far the pay streak extends.
Tony's just marked this spot for us. We're just getting set up here. We'll drill this one down, take the samples, and then head back to wash it up, and we should figure out from that if it's worth mining or not. Snow in September is a little bit strange, but we're just gonna have to suck it up and deal with it, I guess.
The sonic drill vibrates 150 times a second, allowing the hollow shaft to collect a clean core sample.
Well, of course, it would kind of be nice to see what's going to come out of it. I mean, you can't be right all the time, so there's got to be at one point a hole that you're going to get out of it. If I can get out of one of these two holes a decent result, yeah, that is kind of exciting, because there you got another whole year of mining.
Tony has high expectations for this ground. He has a lot riding on it, so I really hope we can find him some good gold. We're going to get these samples washed up here pretty soon, and then we'll know for sure.
The king of the Klondike, Tony Beets, needs to find new ground. After prospecting a piece of land on the other side of the mega cut, he's meeting with drilling expert Liam Ferguson to find out if it holds big gold.
Oh, keeping busy?
Yeah, always busy.
So how did we make out?
We found some pretty interesting stuff. I've got your map here.
Okay. That's the two holes at the top I see, huh?
Yep.
How did it turn out?
First hole, not so good. It looks like some false bedrock in there.
Oh,
that threw us off a bit. But in the second hole, we saw some pretty good grades.
Really?
Yeah.
That's good. What kind of values are we looking at, Liam? If it is an ounce for every 100, I'll be pretty happy with it.
We're looking about ounce per 100 yards,
mm-hmm.
Getting a little better near the bottom, upwards to ounce and a quarter, ounce and a half.
Oh, so
yeah.
I'm very happy with this.
At that rate, the ground would be even richer than the mega cut. 1 week of mining here could earn Tony nearly $1 million.
Perfect.
All right.
Thank you, sir. We'll catch you later.
All right, see you, Tony.
Oh, you bet. That is an awesome piece of ground, so in the near future, we're going to take that out. It's a pretty fair-sized reserve that we came up with, so that makes it very exciting, makes it very good.